So let us go back to the calculation. That is our A vector and B vector, and I will show you how to find the cross product of A, B. So let us have the same vector what we worked with in the last class. So what was the A vector? Can you tell me, anyone?
3i minus j.
Okay, 3i and minus j.
Plus 2k.
Plus 2k, okay. And then what is the B vector?
I plus 3j.
Okay, I means 1i. So
1i plus 3j.
Yes, 3j.
Minus 4k.
Minus 4k, good. So this is the B vector. So we have two vectors here. One is A, one is B, and we will find out A cross B. So A cross B, actually we find this, that is, we do the calculation for cross product. We do the calculation for cross product as determinant. This is in the matrix form. So matrix form, but when we find the value, that is called determinant. So we use the first row as ijk. That will be the first row. And then we will put the numbers from two vectors. One vector is A vector, and the numbers are 3 and minus 1 and 2. So these are the numbers for A vector. And you put the numbers for B vector in the last row. So the numbers will be 1, then 3, then minus 4. Is that okay? So these are the numbers for two vectors as two rows. And now you will find out the value of this determinant. So you will find the values like I, then bracket, then calculation. Okay. So I'm taking the first row, that is ijk, in this selection. You can work with any other row or any other column. Okay, same answer will come. But I'm not going for others. I'm writing I and then the number. So what will be the number? Number will be minus 1 into minus 4.
Minus 6.
Yes. So it is 4 and then minus 6. And then you will put minus j. You will put minus j and then the number. So what will be the number in
minus
this case?
12.
What will be the number?
Minus 12.
Minus 2.
Minus 4? No. Why minus 4?
Minus 12, minus 2.
Yes, minus 12. Yes, minus 12 and then minus 2. It is correct. Okay. And then the last one is plus. Plus k. Plus k into what?
9 plus 1.
9 plus 1. Correct. So this will be 9 plus 1. Now you complete the calculation. So it will be like minus 2i. Minus 2i. And then minus minus plus 14. Plus 14j and then 10k, right? And then 10k. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
So this will be the cross product. So I told you in the last class the dot product is the scalar answer and cross product result is the vector answer. So this is the vector answer, and you have ijk in this vector. This is another vector. That is the understanding of cross product. Okay. Now, if I find out the magnitude of A cross B, what will be the answer? Let me use a different color pen. So I am writing A and B vector cross product. I am finding the value of this cross product result. So what will be the value of this cross product result? This will be root over and then you have already got the answer, that is minus 2i plus 14j plus 10k. So it will be minus 2 square, right? And then plus, and then plus 14 square, and then
plus
10 square. So what will be the last answer? What will be the number? Yes, tell me again, what is that?
10 root 3.
10 root over 3.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so 10 root over 3, possible, yes. So, what is the number in point? 10 root over 3 means what?
17.32.
Exactly, 17.32. 17.32 will be the answer here. So, this is the value of the cross product vector, and now I will tell you what is the meaning of this 17.32. So this is 17.32, fine, but what do you mean by this? What do you understand by this? So let me just not accurately, just we are thinking that this line is my A vector. Okay. Just I am drawing one line, and that is A vector line. And another vector line is this. Say this line is B vector. Okay. So if you have two vector lines, okay, if you have two vector lines, one is A, one is B, okay, and then you can think, or you can draw the, you can draw the parallelogram with these two vectors. You can draw the parallelogram. So you know the parallelogram. What did I tell you? Parallelogram.
Samantarik.
Yes, in Bengali it is called Samantarik. So this is the Samantarik. That is the parallelogram. So if you think about the parallelogram taking two vectors into sides, that parallelogram area, that parallelogram area will be, that parallelogram area will be this 17.32. Okay, so Hafiz al-Islam, you want to say something,
sir? Yes. These vectors in real life, why do we use that? If this in vectors, why do we use?
So this is
in real life.
This is the real life vector I'm just telling now. So if you do the cross product, then you can find out the area of the parallelogram with two vectors given, and that area will be this value, 17.32 square unit. So what is the square unit? Square unit means maybe square inches, square foot, or square mile, or square centimeter. So it depends on the unit. That is, if your A vector is like that, this is one and then two and then three, then four and point something. Say if it is the unit, then this will be that same square unit. If you say this is your centimeter, every centimeter, so this will be 17.32 centimeter square. Okay, if everyone is 1 foot, 1 foot, 1 foot, then it will be 17.32 square foot, like that. Okay, so this is the understanding. So it is one example application, that is cross product can be applied to find out the area of the parallelogram. So which parallelogram? Two sides will be two vectors. So that parallelogram. Okay. Now let me continue with another idea, that is A cross B is our cross product result, and then I am dividing this cross product result by the value of the cross product. Then you already know what is cross product and what is the magnitude. So you can put the values here, and then you can find the answer. The answer is not very, critical. It is very easy. So what is that? Minus 2i, and then plus 14j. Okay. Sorry. Plus 14j. And then plus 10k. So that is the cross product, and this is in the upper side, and in the lower side I am dividing by 17.32. So this is the answer of A cross B divided by A cross B value. So my question is, what is this called? What you will explain this thing? What will be this result?
Unit vector.
Yes, happy is correct. It is unit vector. It is correct. So what will be the direction of this unit vector? This is unit vector, it is correct. So unit vector value is 1, and there will be a direction. So what will be the direction of this unit vector? Bolo, happy?
Sir, it will be from the where you have written centimeter to the top side, like the mid section. That will be the direction.
Okay, tum bolto so duitar majamaji diye jabe.
Yes, yes.
Acha, happy, do you agree with that?
Yes sir, I think the many sab corner je samudrike je corner ta shei corner boro boro
hoy to oitai o bolte chaiche, but it is not correct. Oh. that one is a plus b.
Unit vector is I think 90 degrees, isn't it, from
sir,
a
u, I think sir u.
Azharuddin is right, and another person was saying Rakib, he is also right. So the direction will be unit vector in the perpendicular direction of both, okay, both A and B. So that will be that will be in the air.
Understood.
It will be not in the same plane. Okay, that will be like that. And it is 3D. This is the 90 degree, and this is another 90 degree. Both are 90 degree. Okay, so that will be the concept. So this is unit vector, it is correct, but you have to understand the meaning clearly. The meaning is this unit vector will be going towards a line which is perpendicular to both of the given vectors. Okay, so this is the understanding and why we use the A cross B. Okay, now sir, I will go back to dot product and I will talk about projection. Yes, Rakib. Yes,
sir, about yesterday class, the universal value of U, is it 90 degree always or just
no? I told you about the formula of cross product, that means A cross B, and then I told you A cross B actually A value and B value and sine alpha, and then another vector which will be unit vector and which will be perpendicular to both of the vectors. So you are talking about this U, right?
Like so, like sine 90, will it always be sine 90 degree?
No. What is alpha? What is alpha then? You have to understand what is alpha. So what is alpha? I told you what is alpha.
Sir, alpha is the angle between two vectors.
Angle between A and B or something.
Exactly. So if you say your A is actually x axis and B is actually y axis, then it is 90 degree. but it is not always 90 degree. A can be this and B can be this. So
then it is 0 degree.
No, if it is in the same line, then zero. But if it is 30 degree, 20 degree, possible. Okay.
Oh, that's where 90 is the maximum.
No. Why maximum? Because say A is in this direction and the B vector is going into this direction.
Oh, sorry. Got you.
So the angle is 150 degree. Possible.
Yes, I got.
Alpha can be any angle. This is the angle between two vectors. And if you think about U, in that case, you will say U is the perpendicular to both of the vectors. So both of the vector means it will go up or down, but 90 degree angle. Okay.
Yes, I was talking about the U, like the perpendicular and the divider.
Yes. Now it's okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that
is one thing, sir.
Yes.
What will be the answer of this unit vector? It will remain same, or we have to like calculate something.
About what? About this formula you are taking?
No, sir. A cross B is unit.
Oh, your answer.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
So this is your answer, correct? No problem. Or you can say minus two divided by 17.32, then I. Okay, you can do it by calculator.
32.
And then plus,
yes,
14 by 17.32 j. Okay, and then plus 10 plus 10 divided by 17.32 k.
It is
also possible. Okay. If you do it like this, or if you just keep it like this, no matter. Okay.
Okay, sir.
The understanding is important. Now I will talk about projection, what I did not actually tell you, and I have given some of the questions in your practice sheet, so you need to do the calculation and do the practice at home. And for projection thing, we need to go back to dot product. So just let us assume that this is my A vector and this is my B vector. Okay, we have two vectors here. One is A, one is B. So if I write, or if I want to find, okay, the question is find the projection vector of B on the vector A. If this is the question, that is, I will find out the projection of vector B on the vector A. In that case, I actually mean that the shadow of B, projection of B means the shadow of B. Okay. So shadow of B, where is the shadow? So the shadow will be on the vector A. So the sun is in this position. Okay. This is the position of the sunlight. So if this is your sunlight, then there will be shadow like that, and it will be over the A vector. So this is the shadow. This is the projection. Okay. So if this is the projection, I can find the length of the projection by just using cos formula. So what is the cos? This will be actually B cos alpha. This will be actually B cos alpha. Okay. So I should write the vector arrow mark here. I should keep the arrow mark for AB. But the black one, B cos alpha, this is not vector. This is the value of B. Okay. So this part is what?
That is a scalar term. So
yes,
we do not have any
right
problem with that.
Right. So this is B cos alpha is what? B cos alpha is the length of the shadow. That is the projection. But when I say projection vector, it is actually vector, then it will be in the direction of A, in the direction of A. So when I put the direction of A, then I have to multiply this thing by A unit vector, multiply this thing by unit vector of A. Okay, so you can think of, so what will be the projection? Actually the projection of the vector B, okay, and projection of the vector B in the direction of A will be this. You can write like this is B cos alpha, and then this is B cos alpha, and then A means the vector A divided by value of the vector A. Okay, so you can think like that. This is the unit vector. And if you want to find out the cos alpha, then what you will write, what will be the cos alpha? The cos alpha will be actually
the angle between two vectors
from the dot product formula, right? Right or wrong? Azharuddin, are you saying the same thing?
Yes, sir.
Cos alpha will come from the dot product formula.
Yes,
what
sir.
Is the
yes,
dot
sir,
product
yes.
formula? That is A, then B, then cos alpha. Okay. So that is our, already we know this is the dot product formula. So from this, we can find out B into cos alpha directly, possible. So you can think of, okay, B into cos alpha is the dot product divided by A.
By A.
So possible. Okay, so you can put this here. And how to find the dot product, we already know. So that is also possible. So if you think the other way around, if you think the projection of the vector B, so not B, this time A, projection of the vector A in the direction of B, then we actually mean the similar thing, but in a opposite way. So what will be the opposite way? It will be A cos alpha, okay? A cos alpha, and then the unit vector of B, like this. So this is your understanding, and this is the projection concept. And did I tell you this information? It is also important that if you have say A equal to something means any scalar number into C vector, C is not given here, just I'm telling that another vector which is called C. So if A equal to any number into C, maybe 2 into C, 3 into C, or minus 1 into C, or 5 into C, any number into another vector, if it happens, then A and C vector will be parallel. Did I tell this thing earlier?
No, sir.
Okay, so this is another information we need to know. These two vectors will be parallel vectors if one vector is multiplied by a number and another vector is coming. If this is the situation, then we can say these two vectors are parallel. Okay. It also has the connection with dot product. It also has the connection with dot product. So what is the connection with dot product? The connection is, let me just show it here. So the connection will be, if you want to think about the parallel thing, about dot product thing, so we can find out the angle. by using this formula, right? This formula we can use and we can find out the angle. Is it okay? Someone was asking what is the application of vector. So the dot product of the vector, we use this for finding the angle between two vectors. Okay, so it is one application. Okay, finding angle between two vectors. So
is it process of dot
yes vectors, yes, so by using the dot product we can find the angle between two vectors. So what are the vectors? Maybe you are thinking of one velocity towards Chittagong, another velocity towards Rajshahi. So there will be two lines and then you can find out the angle. Okay, so this is one application. And about the parallel thing, if you find the alpha is zero, okay, if you find the alpha is zero when you calculate that your alpha is actually 0 degree, then what you will understand? You will understand that A and B two are parallel vectors. Okay, you will understand that A and B are two parallel vectors.
Parallel means in Bangla samantaral.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I got the point.
You understand? Parallel means in Bengali samantaral. So oi je parallelogram bollam ekটু আগে ওই সমান্তরিক. Okay, so parallel, hai na, parallel means samantaral. So if you get the alpha angle as zero, the vectors will be parallel, and you understand this is the connected topic with dot product, because by dot product we actually find the angle between two vectors. So what will happen if we have alpha equal to zero? Tale amra parallel to bolbo na. Tokhon what will be the name of the vectors? So when alpha equal to 90 degree, then what will be the name of the vectors? When alpha equal to 90 degree, so there is a name. The name R. Let me just write it down here. Okay, A and B are orthogonal. Orthogonal to each other. So this will be called orthogonal vectors. Okay, orthogonal vectors. So what is orthogonal vectors actually? This means one will be 90 degree to another. Okay, so this is another name. So all these are connected understanding. Okay, now is it okay? Do you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are the things I wanted to tell you.